Good morning, good afternoon, or good night, my fellow Chibits. Today, I am here to bring you an anime review on Log Horizon Season 2. Now, this week's episode begins the new arc, the final arc of Season 2. And it's kind of sad, we're on the final arc. Like, this is definitely going to be probably the final arc of Season 2. And from what Chibits told me last week, there's probably no possibility of a Season 3 for a long time. Probably for another year and a half, 2 years. And so it's kind of sad to hear that this is going to be the final arc that we are going to get to see animated for like a year or two. Or maybe this could possibly be the final one. So, yeah, it's kind of sad. It really is, because even though it's had some ups and downs in Season 2, it's been very fun to know, you know, Log Horizon has just been a really good series, and to see how it's going to be coming to end very, very soon in just a couple weeks, it's sad. It really is. So anyways, this week's episode of Log Horizon, a lot of info dumping. As always, when it comes to Log Horizon, info dumping galore. Now, it's not as bad as some episodes of Log Horizon, which noteworthy, like episode 13, I think it was episode 13 of Log Horizon Season 1. Oh my god, that info dump. But this episode mainly tried to dive into observers, navigators, and harvesters. That's what this episode of Log Horizon tried to dive into, along with hinting at some obvious foreshadowing that's building up in this episode and in this arc. So let's get out all the little details on the side before I dive into the observers, harvesters, and stuff like that. I want to just dive into the other little details. So with this episode, we have some slight hints that the world is still continuing to change, because Serdora in this episode, she says that she can actually cook now. Like, any person in the world, like any adventurer, can now cook with low level cooking skills. Like, they don't really need any cooking skills to cook anymore. So it just goes to show you the world is changing to where people can actually start to cook now. Like, they can cook without having the side class of a cooker. And I don't know if I misunderstood that or not, but that's what I got from the beginning part of this episode when Serdora was starting to be able to cook peas and stuff. So it's pretty much letting us know that if you don't have the, you know, side, you know, class as a cooker, you can still cook now. And it's changing, and that just goes to show you the world is continuously changing slowly and slowly as the series progresses. It's molding into a more of a real-like world. Now, the other parts about this, you also have toward the reoccurring theme in this episode, is how there's adventurers or people that are in this world of Elder Tale Online. They are stuck and they can't adapt to the world at all. They really cannot adapt to what is going on. Like, they really want to just go home. And the only way to fix this problem is by figuring out a way to bring them home. Like, just take them back home. And that's the only way to fix this reoccurring problem. And that's one of the themes that's been building up mostly in Season 2 of Log Horizon. And it's, once again, another major spotlight in this episode that's the main key focus. Like, I remember about 4 or 5 episodes back, I remember when Shiroi was talking with the council and all that, and he's like, should we spread out the gold from all the rich adventurers and give it equally to everybody, since some are having a bad issue with, you know, with jobs and stuff like that? Well, in this episode, Shiroi pretty much lets us know that they are going forward with that idea, and they are going to be taking some gold from the, you know, richest adventurers and spreading it out equally to the poor adventurers, or the people that, you know, want to go home, to try to soften up the tragedy that they're currently going through. And so that's another thing that's been building up in this episode in the past couple episodes, so I just wanted to mention that. Next part to mention, we find out more about Roe 2. Roe 2 is officially confirmed to be the sister of Shiroi. And I'm like, yo. So, the sister. Well, what's really strange about it is Roe 2, in the letter, she announces that she has all the memories that Shiroi has. Like, she knows who Shiroi is and also has, like, his memories, which is really weird. I mean, imagine having two of yourselves, like, two copies of yourself, and has, like, your exact same memories, and they talk, and one's a girl, one's a guy. That'd be fucking weird. It really would be weird. And so, to find out Roe 2 is the sister, the little sister of Shiroi. Yo, that's, I mean, hey, that's a little awesome plot reveal. And we find out all characters, you know, are navigators. And which leads into the main point of the episode. So, the main theme of this arc is focusing on navigators. And these navigators, after looking at this episode, it has been foreshadowed and slowly hinted at to this very point. Like, there's been multiple enemies through the course of Season 2 that have actually been navigators, if you think about it. Like, there's been some weird, bizarre creatures or humanoid beings that's had these weird powers that was, you know, hinted at to this very arc. And so we find out what navigators are, or what happens to alts. Alts become these navigators that have, like, their own soul, this artificial creature that has their own soul, and takes in the memories of, I'm guessing, the person that was the alt account's owner, and they mix themselves on the moon with, like, these different beasts and creatures and stuff to be able to collect this, like, chemical or whatever. I don't know exactly what they're trying to collect, I really don't, but they're trying to collect this stuff from the world. And these are the harvesters. The harvesters are doing that. But the observers are people like Roe too. They're watching and just looking at the way the world is progressing and what they could possibly do to fix the world. And so, yeah, two different sides, two different factions of the navigators. And so the reoccurring theme right here is that the navigators, I could see, could be having a war in the future, because, you know, there's two different factions, two different viewpoints and ideals, and I could see how both of these two could probably have issues between each other, because ones are being very, you know, I guess, aggressive, and one is just trying to be very passive and trying to figure out other options of how they can get this chemical or this thing they want to get through the majority of the series. And that's the episode. That's the episode of Log Horizon. It just sets up all these little plot points. And yeah, tell me your thoughts in the comments below. I mean, how do you feel about this week's episode of Log Horizon? Did you enjoy it? Did you hate it? What's your favorite moments about it? You all have a wonderful day or not, wherever you live. Please be safe. Chibi out.